Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In my previous video, you saw me unpacking, assembling and demonstrating how ultra fast grind technology works for grinding idli batter. In this video, I will show you how this feature for grinding chutney and masalas work. In case you haven't watched my other videos on ultra fast grind, I will leave the links below in the description box. This video is not a sponsored video. Let's get started on how to use this chutney and masala grinding feature introduced by Ultra in this fast grind machine. I will be grinding chutney for this video. I have here 1 cup of chutney dal. For those of you new to the South Indian cooking, this is nothing but dehusked and fried chickpeas. To this, I will be adding roughly about a cup of cut coconuts. You could also add freshly grated coconuts and increase or decrease the quantity of coconut as per your taste. I will also add 2 fresh green chilies. These chilies are for my garden. A small stick of ginger, 1.5 teaspoons of Himalaya pink salt and water as required. You can also add chilies as per your taste. First, let's assemble the grinder. For a detailed instruction on how to assemble ultra fast grind, please view my unboxing and assembling video. Link is below. Once the grinder is assembled, add water into the mixing bowl and add in all the ingredients. Set the timer and press the program chutney and masala. The grinding stones in ultra fast grind with the chutney and masala program grind in both the directions. This is to ensure that everything is incorporated and it grinds at a faster rate than the one direction grinding stone. During the grinding process, you will see that not all the dal and the coconut are towards the grinding stone. To incorporate all this well towards the grinding stone, pause the grinder by pressing the power button. Open the lid and use the spatula given. Close the lid and press once again chutney and masala program to continue the grinding. I first set the timer for 5 minutes but realized this chutney needed longer grinding time because I used frozen coconut. I rectified this and increased the timer function by another 5 minutes. By the end of 6 minutes, it was almost ground and I could test the chutney consistency with the batter tester. For the purpose of demonstration, I let the machine complete the program with the timer. Thank you. The grinder stopped at the end of the program after beeping for a few seconds. The chutney was ground to a butter-like consistency. Now, to transfer the contents, switch off the machine, lift the lid carefully, remove the lock and the stones. Tilt the bowl on the veg provided and then transfer its contents. For seasoning this chutney, heat a small pan with 2 teaspoons of oil, add 2 teaspoons of urad dal and fry until it is lightly browned. Then add 1 teaspoon of black mustard seeds till it splutters, add a pinch of asafoetida and finish it off with fresh curry leaves. Mix all the seasonings into the chutney and garnish with chopped coriander leaves. My personal review on this chutney program from Fast Grind is that it's not suitable for my small family for regular use. I would have to grind a huge quantity and it is also in the end too many bits and pieces to wash. I personally prefer a blender to grind small quantities. On the other hand, the chutney didn't get hot during the grinding process and that definitely added to the taste of the chutney. I will use this whenever I have to grind a larger quantity of chutneys or masalas. I hope you enjoyed this video and this was informative for you. Thank you for watching. In case you're new to my channel, kindly subscribe. Hit that bell button to receive notifications for the latest videos I have uploaded. I post one new video every week on food from scratch, Swiss country living and our gardening experiences. Until next time, bye-bye.